Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we wanted to do another demonstration of our turnkey ore system. This is our 1 ton per hour system, and I want to walk you through the system, and then we can take a look at some of the ore we're going to be running, and then we'll fire up the system and see what we get. So it starts here with this jaw crusher module, and the ore will be dumped into the hopper here. The hopper vibrates down and feeds this 8x12 jaw crusher, which crushes it down to about 1 inch or 3/4 inch minus. It discharges down onto this conveyor behind me, brings the material crushed up into this fine ore hopper. The fine ore hopper is really a holding bin, but it also allows us to meter the feed up to the hammer mill very evenly. Underneath, there's a feeder that you can adjust the rate of feed, which meters the feed onto this conveyor up into the 16x12 hammer mill here. This hammer mill right now has 20 chrome hammers in it and a 0.8 millimeter slotted screen. And at this size screen, about 70% of the material passes 30 mesh and about 50% passes 50 mesh. We run it wet so it forms a really nice slurry. It'll discharge down here onto our shaker table. This is one of our 4x8 shaker tables rated at 1 ton per hour. The quartz and other gang material will flow off into the number 4. The heavy dense sulfides and gold will be caught in these grooves, come up under the water bar. Once it reaches up here under the water bar, the water washes the sulfides away that do make it up onto the cleaning plane, leaving a nice clean line of gold that comes down into the number 1 and number 2 concentrates. The shaker table has 2 safety grooves at the bottom that run all the way across, and this will capture anything that doesn't quite make it up into the cleaning plane, into the number 1. So the number 1 and number 2 are where most of your values are going to be. There's a number 3 port here that the sulfides will form a band at the end of the grooves, and it will work its way down into the number 3 middlings bucket here. The tailings are set up to flow into a spiral classifier, and the spiral classifier has a little settling basin here. The quartz particles that settle down through that basin are augered out and dewatered into a super sack there that can be either rerun for liberating more gold if there's enough values, or they're dewatered, and so they're a lot easier to deal with and it doesn't fill up your tailings pond. Right now we have the spiral classifier set on the finest setting, so somewhere around 150 or 200 mesh material is sent to the final tailings pond. This is a concrete basin we've buried here for our water, and we can recirculate the water through the system continuously, so you don't have to have fresh water to run this system. The shaker table takes between 5 and 7 US gallons a minute to operate, and we add another 1 or 2 US gallons to the hammer mill. So altogether, this whole system runs on less than 10 gallons a minute of water, and again, which can all be recirculated. So let's go take a look at the ore we're gonna be running, and then we'll get this thing fired up. So here's some of the ore we're going to be running today, and this is a quartz hydrothermal vein ore. It has free gold and a little bit of sulfides in it, and we'll talk about that in a minute. But we have about 60 buckets of this stuff to run, and we weighed 5 or 6 of them, and it averages about 65 pounds. So we're running somewhere between 3,500 and 4,000 pounds for this sample. But let me show you some of the ore here we're talking about. These streaks you can see here are the sulfides associated with the ore. The main sulfide in this ore is a pyrrhotite, which is an iron sulfide. There's a little bit of pyrite and a little bit of chalcopyrite, but other than that, it's pretty much quartz and a little bit of sulfides, and there's some free gold in here as well.
Thank you.
here's the number one bucket that we got off the table. I've panned it down a little bit, but you can see in the sun, it's a pretty good showing there. A lot of fine gold. Again, this was from about 3,500 pounds of ore, and this is the number one. So we're gonna take the number two and rerun it. We probably got about 2 or 3 gallons of number two that we're gonna rerun on the shaker table and upgrade it even more, and then we'll pan that down and see what that looks like. Okay, so we wanted to show you kind of what we ended up with after our run. These are the number three kind of middlings, and this is the sulfide rich middlings that came off the table, and we ended up with two buckets of these. And so I've cleaned out the number three here. This yellow bucket is empty, and I've taken all the number two and number one away, and right now we have three of these tubs of number two. And the number two is real heavy sulfides. And we're gonna show you now, the number one, it was easy. You could just pan it out a little bit and you could see the gold. But now for the number two, we're gonna turn the tail back on and I'm gonna clean up the number two and get a high grade number one with mostly gold. A little bit in number two, but most of these sulfides are going to end up going down to number three middlings where we'll catch. Okay, so what we're doing now is we're taking our number two and we're rerunning it on our shaker table to clean it up. And so there's a lot of sulfides in here with a little bit of gold, and we want to get rid of most of the sulfides so we don't have to deal with them. And so we're running them on the same table that we used for our production run. But we're using the table now as a finishing table to clean up our gold and eliminate a lot of our sulfide concentrates. So I'm feeding our number two right down here at the base of the ramp, going down about halfway down the table. And it's forming a nice wide band of sulfides that are running down. And we've adjusted the splitter and the trough there to capture all the sulfides and run them back into our number three middlings trough. So we're not losing any of this to tailings. This is all worth saving. But our strategy is to get as much of the free gold out as possible that you can then smelt and sell directly to a refiner rather than boxing up or putting a bunch of sulfides in a barrel and sending them off for further processing. You want to get as much free gold out as you possibly can. Okay, here's our very, very, very fine gold that we ended up with. This is the number two concentrates from our initial run that we've rerun on the table, and this is what came out in the number one port. So you can see there, it's actually not very much gold, but it's very, very, very fine and makes a really nice looking crescent in the pan. It's easily 325 mesh minus, almost all that gold is. Okay, so what we're doing now is, this is actually really just a check. I've taken a bucket of our number three middlings and we're running it back on the table to see if we get any gold. And in the past, we found that 95-98% of the free gold ends up in the number one and number two. So if we see any gold up here, it should be very, very, very little, and it should be very, very, very fine. So that's what we're doing here, and if we see any gold, we'll get the camera on and we'll show you what we get. So we've been running maybe half a bucket of the number three middlings here, and you can see right here on the cleaning plane, this is that little band of sulfides, and there is no gold to speak of at all. And so that tells me that we ended up with almost 100% of the free gold ended up in the number one and number two. So any value that's associated with the number three in this case is going to be locked up in the sulfides because it's not liberated. We're not seeing any free gold on the table at all. Okay, so here's the gold that we got from our table and our run. And we panned it down a little bit, but you can see there's quite a bit of gold in there. And this is everything out of our number one and number two concentrates. And I've got it fanned out so you can see the gold, but over on this side, there's still a little pile of black sand. There's actually a big old piece of gold on top, but There's a little pile of sulfides here. And so we're gonna take all of the material in the pan, put it into our cast iron frying pan, and we're gonna roast it over our furnace, drive off the sulfur, and then we're gonna smelt it down into a button. Okay, we've got our gold concentrates up on the furnace there, and they're roasting away. They're just about finished. And so we're gonna take them, cool them off, weigh them out, and then we'll mix up a slag recipe. Okay, so here's our 30 grams of high-grade material from the shaker table. I've mixed 30 grams of silica, 30 grams of soda ash, 90 grams of borax, and I added a little bit of potassium nitrate this time to see if we can oxidize and maybe clean up some of that gold a little bit more. So I'm gonna take the top off my furnace here, pour it right in the crucible, put the lid back on, and we're ready to go. Okay, so here's our pour in our cone mold. It's cooled down. I'm gonna knock it out in this steel bin. And there's our little button that's starting to show there. So I'll bust it out of there with a hammer and we'll take a look at what we got. So there's our button. So I'll get some of the slag knocked off and we'll take a look and get it weighed. All right, here's our button. We're gonna get it weighed out here on our scale. And it comes in right just under 16 grams. So it ended up being right about a quarter ounce a ton. And that's really a minimum value. I would actually say that the ore probably has a little bit higher grade than that. There's probably some value left over in the middlings. And in the future, I wanna do a video where I take that middling fraction and grind it up really, really fine and see if we can liberate any more gold. So stay tuned for that one. And then I also wanted to, at the end of the video here, answer a question we get a lot is, what grade do you need to make a system like this profitable? And there's a lot of factors that go into that question, but kind of rule of thumb would be that if you just have a dump pile or tailings or something that's sitting on the surface and you just have to go dig it up, I would estimate that somewhere around a quarter ounce per ton would be enough value to make a turnkey system profitable. If you actually have to go underground and do some mining to get it out, you're probably looking at half an ounce plus per ton to make that profitable. So anyway, I wanted to throw those out there. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And I think it was a great example of being able to take some rocks and in just a couple hours, turn it into a gold button. So you kind of saw the process from start to finish there. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And we'll see you on the next video.